especially the dignitaries of the dais, and all who are enthusiastically participating in this seminar. This afternoon seminar, that is the participation in nation building, which is a sort of an outcome of almost 10-15 days of a serious discussion on social justice forum on Lokpa, which this desk, the people, most of the people were here. We sat together, thought over how the Lokpa bill has to be, what it should include, and what it should not omit. So as an outcome of after that meeting, we thought we cannot just disperse. So we have to bring our Dalit intellectuals, Dalit activists, Dalit concerned people who are concerned in Dalit realities. We have to bring all of us together and think over what we have been, what we are now, and what we have to move ahead and far. Now, Dalit participation in nation building is nothing new. We know that not only from the time of independence, even much, much before that, it is the Dalits, the OBC community, the tribals, we have contributed our best to building the nation. So this is just an occasion for us to remind to ourselves that what are the areas we have built up the nation and where we stand today, how the nation recognizes our participation, our contribution to building the nation. I think this is a kind of self-reminder, and then tell the nation again and again and again that we are second to none in this country in terms of building the nation, in terms of building this economy, in terms of building its political discourse. So we have participated at every aspect of building the nation. I think this is a good occasion that we remind ourselves first and foremost, and then tell the world, tell India, tell the policy makers, especially tell the caste world, the caste India, that we are second to none. So this is where we have come together, and we have got on the dais excellent people who have committed themselves to a long-standing building up the nation, especially this developing India, in the way kind of self-sufficient India, in different capacities and different ways. So I would like to specially invite our honorable guest, Teesta Stendralwad, who is a Padma Shri awardee, has been in this activist world for many, many, many years. Started her life as a journalist, but today she is known more as a human rights activist, as a person who can contribute, who can involve herself in all the activities that affect the country, that affect the human rights. So today, on behalf of the people on the dais, on behalf of all our Dalit brethren, I warmly welcome Teesta Stendralwad. Warm welcome. I would like to also welcome all our dignitaries. Professor Vivek Kumar. Vivek Kumar is a professor of sociology at the Jayanagar University. I know the moment I enter the world for Professor Vivek Kumar, you have a ovation for him. Not only because he has got a lot of students here, but because very much he has been into this Dalit intellectual world very prominent and very visible. So this Dalit idea has been very much visible in the forefront thanks to Professor Vivek Kumar. And I would like to welcome our eminent Dalit committed, our veteran, our mentor, Dr. Amar Singh Ji. Dr. Amar Singh Ji is the executive director of the Food Corporation of India. Many of you would know him personally, and a lot of people would know him by his contribution, especially during 2002, this Bhopal Declaration, where he has been the backbone. And also for the common concerns, he has been like our elder brother. Whenever we have some issues, it is before we people call, it is he calls us, tells us we have to come together. And in all of the discussions, it is his contribution takes a long way with us. So that way, he has contributed himself, he has contributed his might I would like to welcome Sri Parthivakar. Sri Parthivakar, I know most of people know him. May not know him as Parthivakar as an individual, but know him by what he does through National Campaign on Dalit Human Rights in Sri Hacha. Comes from a Christian background, but also from a Dalit background. He has never compromised his Dalit identity because he's a Christian. Or he has never compromised his Christian values of justice, truth and fellowship, brotherhood for his Dalit identity. So here is a man who very excellently blends his being a Dalit and his being a Christian. Both the courage to stand with his word as a Dalit and the fineness to give himself as a brother of the country, as a brother of our world. So here we have got Sri Parthivakar. A warm welcome to you. I would like to welcome Dr. Dalip Mangal. I know too much about him, but I know that he is a very good writer. He accepts a warm welcome. And I know more than us, there are a lot of people who are sitting on the down on the floor who have silently contributed a lot. And I also see a lot of young faces. Young faces are always a silent hope for the Dalit world. And here we have got not just young faces, but a lot of future Dalit discourse. A lot of future Dalit intellectual ideas going permeate in this world. We have got also a number of activists who have been fully into the field, fully involved in intervening in the political, in the social, in the cultural discourse, where we have to establish ourselves, where we have to make our identity visible, our identity felt, and that way to build the nation. So I welcome all of you and each and every one of you present on the August 9th floor. Welcome. And finally, I again welcome all of us. We welcome ourselves.